inside of the hemisphere, between white matter inside of hemisphere, present places with a gray matter, and this gray matter has name basal nuclei. And last, rhinocephalon, olfactory brain, rhinocephalon. Four departments in telencephalon. Four departments. Cortex, opalium, white matter, basal nuclei, and rhinocephalon. Today, we will speak only about pallium and about a hemisphere. A hemisphere has three surfaces. Upper lateral surface, all of this. Middle surface and inferior surface. I think it is not necessary to write because everything present, everything, maybe then I tell you some moments what is necessary to write. But now listen to me and see here. Upper lateral surface, medial surface and inferior surface. Next, we have five lobes. That is frontal, parietal, occipital, temporal, and inside of this deep groove present small lobe which is isolated from all another. It has name insula. Main borders between lobes, between frontal lobe and parietal, present central groove, sulcus centralis. It is border, sulcus centralis, border between frontal and parietal. Next, sulcus lateralis, lateral groove. It is border between temporal and frontal, and temporal and parietal. Next, here it is on medial surface, sulcus parieta occipitalis. One again. Sulcus parieta occipitalis. It present on medial surface and only small part go to upper lateral surface, and we continue it and speak about border between parietal and occipital lobes. Next, we start from lobus frontalis, lobus frontal lobe. Frontal lobe, it is everything what in front from sulcus centralis. First groove, sulcus precentralis or anterior central groove, and between sulcus centralis and sulcus precentralis, present gyrus, gyrus precentralis, or the same anterior central gyrus, gyrus precentralis, anterior central gyrus. It is cortical center of motor analyzer. What is it? It is from apparatus of movements, go impulses to this gyrus, and from this gyrus start pyramidal tracts. Do you know names of pyramidal tracts? Cortica spinalis anterior and lateral, and tractus cortica nuclearis. From gyrus precentralis, tumor in this region, it's what happened. If we have tumor in gyrus precentralis, it is paralyzed. Opposite half of human body will be paralyzed. All muscles will be paralyzed. That is motor analyzer here. It is clear? Next. Two frontal grooves, sulcus frontalis superior and sulcus frontalis inferior. These two grooves separate frontal lobe into three gyri, gyrus frontalis superior, gyrus frontalis medius, and gyrus frontalis inferior. I think not so difficult, yes? No?
Oh.
Well. In look here, that is gyrus frontalis medius. Gyrus frontalis medius. In central part of this gyrus, present center of the turin of the head and eyes in opposite direction. That is central part of medial frontal gyrus. Posterior part of the same gyrus, it is center of the writing, possibility to write, or motor analyzer of the written speech, motor analyzer of the written speech, possibility to write. It is posterior part of gyrus frontalis medius. Next, gyrus frontalis inferior. In posterior part of gyrus frontalis inferior, present cortical center of the speech, possibility to speak, with the help of gyrus frontalis inferior posterior part. Next, parietal lobe. Parietal lobe, it has sulcus postcentralis or posterior central groove, and between central and posterior central groove present gyrus postcentralis. It is the cortical center of the skin analyzer. Touch, temperature, pain, heat is gyrus postcentralis. Another part of parietal lobe divides with the help of sulcus intraparietalis into two lobules, lobulus parietalis superior and lobulus parietalis inferior. In superior lobule, present center of the cerebrognosus. In inferior part, we have two gyri. First of all, look here, sulcus lateralis, go into inferior parietal gyrus, and gyrus which surround sulcus lateralis has name gyrus supramarginalis. This gyrus supramarginalis, it is center of practical movements. For example, practical and sport movements which you receive in time of your practical in your praxis, in your job, that is situated in gyrus supramarginalis. Next, sulcus temporalis superior finished the same in inferior parietal lobule, and gyrus which surround sulcus temporalis superior has name gyrus angularis. Gyrus angularis, it is visual center of the written speech. It is possibility to read, center of the written speech, center of the written speech, possibility to read. Gyrus angularis. That is all about parietal lobe. Now, temporal lobe, lobus temporalis. It is two grooves, sulcus temporalis superior and sulcus temporalis inferior. And these two grooves divides temporal lobe into three gyri: gyrus temporalis superior, gyrus temporalis medius, yes, and gyrus temporalis inferior. Superior temporal gyrus, gyrus temporalis superior. In central part of this gyrus, present center of the hearing, auditory center. Posterior part of the same gyrus has hearing center of the speech, possibility to understand speech. It is posterior part of gyrus temporalis superior. And last in temporal lobe, central part of gyrus temporalis medius and gyrus temporalis inferior has center of vestibular function. Do you know vestibular apparatus, balance, coordination of movements? That is central part of medial and inferior temporal gyrus. Last center, it is center of the vision, visual center. It is from both sides of sulcus calcarinus. Here it is on middle surface, present sulcus calcarinus, and this groove separates cuneus and gyrus lingualis. And in both of these sides, in cuneus and in gyrus lingualis, take place visual analyzer, cortical center of visual analyzer. Possibility to see. Have you got a manual? Somebody give me, please. Diencephalon, third ventricle, cerebencephalon, and brain cortex, supralateral surface. Inferior temporal, inferior surface. Till inferior surface. Inferior surface not necessary to read. Only upper lateral or superior lateral surface. From telencephalon, brain cortex, and superolateral surface. Till inferior surface. Inferior surface not necessary to read. Well, that is all. No. Preparate. The same on preparate. That is right hemisphere, medial surface, inferior, and upper lateral or superior lateral surface. It is corpus callosum. Today somebody answered that corpus callosum is above of foramen, and that is roof together form roof of the third ventricle. Yes. Well, what about bodies between lobes? Sulcus centralis, sulcus precentralis, and sulcus postcentralis. It is gyrus precentralis and gyrus postcentralis. Sulcus frontalis superior, sulcus frontalis medius. Gyrus frontalis superior, gyrus frontalis medius, and gyrus frontalis inferior. Sulcus lateralis, it is this is sulcus lateralis. Maybe here more better to see island, or look here, that is sulcus lateralis, and if we divide brain, here it is, we can see this isolated part of cortex inside of sulcus lateralis. Here it is, here, that is insula, island, insula. Sulcus lateralis go into, okay. Everything what behind of sulcus centralis, all of this part, it is parietal lobe. And in parietal lobe present gyrus postcentralis, and here it is sulcus intraparietalis, and it's divide parietal lobe into two lobules, lobulus parietalis superior and lobulus parietalis inferior. And look here, sulcus lateralis go into lobulus parietalis inferior and finished here. And this part of brain which surround end of sulcus lateralis, it is end of lateral groove, and this part of brain surround lateral groove, it has name gyrus supramarginalis. And another sulcus temporalis superior also go into inferior parietal lobule, and this gyrus which surround end of sulcus temporalis superior has name gyrus angularis. It is gyrus supramarginalis. It is gyrus angularis. It is sulcus temporalis inferior, and gyrus temporalis superior, gyrus temporalis medius, and gyrus temporalis inferior. Last moment. Maybe it is also okay. Good. Okay, that is sulcus lateralis, and from sulcus lateralis start two branches, ramus anterior and ramus ascendens. They go into gyrus frontalis. Help me. Inferior. Gyrus frontalis superior, gyrus frontalis medius, and gyrus frontalis inferior. These branches go into gyrus frontalis inferior and divide inferior part of this gyrus into three parts. Pars orbitalis in front from ramus anterior. Pars triangularis, look like triangle, pars triangularis between ramus anterior and ramus ascendens. And last, pars opercularis, behind of ramus ascendens. These three parts, pars orbitalis, triangularis, and opercularis, all of them in gyrus frontalis inferior. Here it is. Ramus anterior and ramus ascendens. Here it is pars orbitalis, pars triangularis, and pars opercularis. Now that is all.